Fort Kenya has flouted the constitution, its own constitution. And because of that, Wetangula and team have been in office illegally. From 2011, there was supposed to be an NDC in 2014 or 2015. But that election was not held. There would have been another NDC in 2019. That also was not held. So two consecutive elections have been skipped. In fact, one of the reasons why the National Executive Council dismissed Moses Wetangula was a result of his failure to provide leadership so that the party can hold elections regularly and enhance our democracy. As you are aware, following his dismissal in May last year, he went to court, obtained orders restraining the registrar from effecting changes, and also keeping himself as the leader with the use of the court order. Members of Fort Kenya do not recognize Moses Wetangula as party leader. You are aware. When it became apparent that the conflict was not being resolved, that there are two leaderships, two groups within the party, sometime last year towards the end, and pursuant to the resolutions of the National Executive Council and the General Council of 2019, the Secretary General convened a National Delegates Congress, which was to be held in November last year. That was quite in order. It followed resolutions of the organs of the party. Wetangula again and the group went to court and obtained orders stopping that NDC and election therefore. We have stayed since then without an election, without an activity. He has enjoyed moving about with the use of the court order as the leader of Fort Kenya. In the meantime, you are aware that time is not on our side. The year is ending, and the beginning of 2022, people will be preparing for elections for various positions when election is called in August next year. We will not have time then to hold an NDC because of a concentration on the national election, the general election that will be held next year. And therefore, we failed after Wetangula promised to call an NDC in August. Sometimes in July he promised that there will be an NDC in August. We have always disagreed with him and team, but on this one we agreed. We said yes, we have always wanted to have an NDC that will resolve the matters of Fort Kenya. So we did welcome the idea of an NDC in August. But now August ended. Even after the Secretary General appealed to him to discuss the debt for the NDC, he was not interested, and then August went and passed without an NDC. September has gone without an NDC. We are now in mid-October. You see, December is just at the corner. It may not be possible to have an election in December or even January. So, pursuant to the previous resolutions, and even the notice that had been given, we decided with colleagues, members of the National Executive Council and leadership that when we met last time, after we announced that we are prepared to go to election, which did not take place because Wetangula did not want to sit and agree on the debt.